Hello, movie fans. I am here visiting with Ray Birmingham. And Ray was born and raised in Hobbs and had a long, how many years? 43 years. Mm-hmm. That's right, career as a baseball coach. In fact, he is recognized as the winningest baseball coach in the state of New Mexico and in the Mountain West. That's a pretty big deal. He coached here at NMJC for a number of years, where he won several championships for the baseball team and moved on to the bigger school, UNM. And I am a Lobo. I graduated from UNM.
Oh, good for you.
When you were here at NMJC, I heard stories about you and Steve McCleary having to clear the field, set up the field yourselves, bringing in bleachers and doing all kinds of crazy things in order to even have a baseball field.
That's true. Steve and I have an area that is now where the dorms are at, the nice dorms. We picked that spot for the baseball field. And Dr. Hayes said, no, I have plans for that. You're going to put it over here by the hospital. At that time, that was the runoff for all the hospital, the Halliburton, the Wellex, the bus, all the cement and blacktop that went all the way to Ocotillo. All that water ran into a hole that was right there in that field. So we had a hole that was probably 10 feet deep and about 10 feet wide that ran from the pavement by the hospital, that road that runs by the hospital, all the way almost to the circle at the school, the circle that goes pavement that goes around the school. And so I spent many evenings filling that thing with dirt so we could have a baseball field there. And College of Southwest, I'd built their field, and they were gracious enough to share NMJC's baseball team and College of Southwest baseball team shared a field for practice and games in 1990. And by 91, we had had the field built. But yes, we worked our tails off, Steve and I. And there's so many funny stories. Steve caught himself on fire.
That's funny.
Turned out funny, but at first it wasn't. You know, there's a lot of stories that he and I, we were tired. We worked day in and day out, night and day.
Well, your dedication certainly paid off. Anywhere that you've been, it did here at New Mexico Junior College. And now our baseball field is named after you. What do you think makes you a successful coach? Or makes anyone a successful coach?
You don't know it all, and you'll never know it all. You know, you're never gonna have it completely figured out. But if you work hard, the other one is being a good people person. I was lucky enough to be around Tommy Lasorda and Bill Verdon, who were big league managers, successful at what they did. And they both told me, as I was bugging them to ask them how to be a good coach, just told me, just relax, just be a good people person and work hard. And they're right.
A gifted coach is going to be someone who brings their team together. And I know that you're known for a lot of your team building exercises that you would do.
Yeah, those are important. Yes,
are they notorious?
Well, yeah, I guess they might be. In some cases, they are notorious. I would have Marine days when enough guys had messed up. It was just 2 hours of heavy exercise. Bless me, I was at the right time at the right place to build men. And I felt like that's how you had to do it. And nobody was going to get hurt by it. I always talked like the guy in the other dugout was in trouble because they were playing us. And I always told kids how good they could be. They may not be there yet, but probably I coached about 5,000 kids and they all got better. I thought many of them played in the big leagues and many of them won a World Series and many of them went on. But I'm also proud of the kids that went on to do something in business world or in private world and be good husbands and good people.
What makes baseball so special?
Baseball is a romance. Baseball is passion. Baseball is blue collar. Baseball is anybody can come out of the woodwork. It's not a body type. It's just people with passion. And baseball has such dark, deep, strong history. And they've had characters, and characters were made bigger than life, beginning with Babe Ruth and go back to Ty Cobb and Napoleon LaJoie. And we've had names like Catfish and Blue Moon, an oil can, you know, Shoeless Joe. We're the fiber of America. We are what America is. And it's a good place to sit and have a conversation with people and enjoy a nice summer day or summer evening and not have a high tempo to where you can still watch the game and still pay attention to each other. I always feel like if a dad and a son would just play catch, they get to know each other better through a good game of catch.
Speaking of that, we're going to be talking about Field of Dreams, and that has a big role in the Field of Dreams.
Field of Dreams is special for me because the guy's name was Ray. He was building a field because he had this dream of what would happen. And I was building the baseball field at New Mexico Junior College because I felt like someday we could be national champions. So it was really special for me. My reaction to Field of Dreams, well, obviously this guy hears his voice and he has to answer this voice. The chase to find the answer, to figure it out, to stop the voices, he has to go build this field at his farm. His farm's in bankruptcy and this guy had to build this field. He had to see it through. Everybody was trying to get him to stop and he couldn't do it. He had to have this answer. And baseball is that. It consumes you. It eats you day and night, and it becomes all you think about. And I've been there. I've lived it for 43 years.
One of the characters is the one played by Burt Lancaster, Doc Moonlight Graham. You know, he went on to be a doctor. One thing that he says is, we don't recognize life's most significant moments while they're happening. Back then, I thought, well, there'll be other days. I didn't realize that that was the only day.
Well said.
There's so much philosophy in this film.
Throughout the movie.
That was one of the lines that really struck me. There's some great quotes in this film. Sure, you know them. If you build it,
they will come.
And is this heaven?
Or is this?
No, it's Iowa.
That's right. It's Iowa.
I love it.
That's right.
When Ray Kinsella is talking to the players, he's talking to Shoeless Joe Jackson, who was one of the eight men out, one of the Black Sox eight. Ray Kinsella said, well, where did you come from? And he said, where did we come from? Well, you can't believe how many guys wanted to play here. We had to beat them off with a stick. And you know, the ones that were banned from playing, they wanted to play so badly. He goes on to say, Ty Cobb wanted to play, but none of us could stand the blank, blank, blank when we were alive. So we told him to stick it. That was another one of my favorites. I had to write down.
And that is so true. It's probably watched Bull Durham, Field of Dreams, Love the Game, probably 100 times. I can't help it.
Yeah.
And then, like I say, I knew that Iowa line. I had forgotten it. But yeah. It's one of my favorite lines.
So did you watch the game between the Yankees and the White Sox that they played in August?
How perfect was that?
Oh,
it's like they scripted it.
Yeah.
It was like it was scripted. And the ballpark was small, so I knew there'd be some taters. And the crowd, that people were just begging to be at that game.
Did you ever go to Iowa to see the field?
I have not. It's on my bucket list. There were several kids that I coached that were in that game. And the thing about baseball is that it's a kid's game. And when you go hang around those guys, they're big kids. When they get out there with their glove on, most of them are still big kids. And it just brings about that beautiful, simple part of life. It's always 90 feet and hope you take a left. It's always 60 feet, 6 inches, you know, and it can't change. It's the one pure thing that we've been able to try to hold together as time moves on. And I mean, I can just talk about the beauty of the game. We all remember the first time our dad took us to a big league game. And I know everybody, Billy Crystal talks about it, Bob Costas talks, and we all remember that it was almost like going to church.
Yeah. What was your first big league game?
My first big league game was in Arlington, but my first pro game was in the early 60s at Hobbs Pirates. And I had the bat because I was in love with the shortstop. And let me tell you about that. This is weird. So the shortstop, I loved it. They called him the stick. And he couldn't hit very well. And he gave me one of his broken bats, which I still have today. And it says Hobbs Pirates on it. And the shortstop was a guy named Gene Michael. And Gene Michael played shortstop for the Yankees as the years went on and became their president. I love the game, and I feel like I'm a lucky man. I got to be part of it for so long.
Well, we appreciate you. You've done a great job. And thank you for what you continue to do for New Mexico Junior College, because that's where I am right now.
But, go T-Bird.
Go T-Bird. It's great that you've never lost this connection. So we appreciate you.